In the first 24 years of Jackrabbit softball, the program never won 20 games. Then, Donna Hansen Mertz arrived at South Dakota State. Over the next three seasons, SDSU would record 100 victories on the diamond, thanks in large part to the all-around play of the shortstop from Marcus, Iowa. Hansen won the North Central Conference's Freshman of the Year award in 1994, hitting .461 as the Jacks finished one win shy of the league championship. The following season, SDSU won 14 straight games and a school record 43 in all, making the NCAA tournament for the first time. She hit .357 while stealing 17 bases for that record-breaking team. In her final year in yellow and blue, she scored 33 runs while hitting .351, helping the squad record its second straight 30-win season. Her career totals still rank in the top 10 in 9 different categories, highlighted by her school record .381 batting average.
Good morning, everybody. 60 feet. That is the distance from home plate to first base on a college softball diamond. Growing up in rural Iowa, I never really contemplated the distance. I just knew hit the ball, and very importantly, drop the bat, and run like crazy. The infields weren't necessarily groomed, and we were lucky if we had grass in the outfield. But to us, fast pitch softball was a place to be with our friends, to compete against rival neighboring towns and have fun. I never thought about the places that it would take me and the opportunities that playing this great sport could provide. Like most, moving away from home to attend college opened doors to many newfound freedoms. Although I didn't have a scholarship, I was encouraged to come and practice and walk on the team. This afforded me the ability to transition from the life I had known and enjoyed to my new life at SDSU. Unknown to me at the time, it also provided me with lifelong friends that love softball as much as myself and the structure and discipline that has lasted me a lifetime. The bonds with my teammates, some who are here with me today, Melissa, Sue, Jesse, Shelly, Jill, Shelly, and many more, created the stability and the drive to compete for continual improvement until I was offered a scholarship. As a group, our shared blood, sweat, and tears is what drove us to greatness. It was just last year that we came back as a team on campus to celebrate the 25th anniversary of the winningest season from 1996. It was during this celebration and over several libations that we shared what our experiences meant to us individually as well as collectively. As a team, we overcame adversity as we had 3 coaches in 4 years. Reflecting back on that time, I'm not certain we could have had that success unless we had each other for support, if we played selflessly, and held one another accountable. 2022 is an important year as it marks the 50th anniversary of Title IX. It is hard to believe that at one time, that ability to compete in sports for women was either limited, modified, or non-existent. Even after the advent of Title IX in 1972, it has taken over a generation of women to be recognized for excellence in athletics, and in some regards are still striving for that equivalence. That being said, I want to recognize those women that have carried that fight, as well as SDSU for laying the groundwork for myself and the future generations. Lastly, I would like to thank South Dakota State University for this humbling honor of being inducted into the 2022 Athletics Hall of Fame class. Thinking about the accolades I was able to accomplish, none would have been possible without the encouragement of my family, my friends, my coaches, my teammates, and most importantly, the support of South Dakota State University. Despite all the things that I have been able to achieve, watching my young daughters, Casey and Haley, take up the bat and run that 60 feet makes me realize that the best is yet to come. Thank you for this great honor.